Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everybody. Out of series of lectures, today's number is 53rd, and today I am going to discuss and share my knowledge about the eggs which we are eating daily, and for more than 50 years doctors were telling to all of us globally that eating egg causes heart attack, and they mentioned within this 40 years time that eggs are full of cholesterol and saturated fatty acid, and they mentioned that the yellow yolk and the white one means that is jelly like albumin, these two components are there, and out of which the one which is yellow yolk, yellow color goes to beta carotenoid, and that yellow, they mentioned that it is full of bad cholesterol. But the recent publication in Journal of Medical Science, that is called the Journal of the American Medical Association. In Journal of American Medical Association, they have mentioned that what concept, what belief they were having some 40 years before is totally wrong. Today's concept is that eggs are having heart preventing chemicals, substances, components, and especially in that yellow one, that is yellow one, yeah. So how they came to this conclusion, after the analysis, they found that yellow yolk is full of beta carotene, it is full of monounsaturated fatty acid, and for your kind information, globally, even WHO has given the recognition that egg is one of the best protein in the world, and it is absolute protein, and it is one of the purest form of protein. And the value of this protein, egg protein, is 96, and all other proteins are compared with this because all other proteins are adulterated. Secondly, this egg protein, what we are eating, there is no age restriction, no age limit. Starting from 1 year up to 100 years, in any age group, people can eat it, and this is very easy to digest. Digestible and very easy to cook. This is the only protein, that is egg, which we can cook within 3-4 minutes time. But for other protein, you have to cook at least for 30 to 40 minutes. So if you consider all these factors, eggs are one of the most important and purest form of protein, and which is very rich in many vitamins, in many minerals. For example, this your yellow yolk, which some 40 years ago the doctors were advising just throw it away. That yellow one is the most important. It is very rich in vitamin D, and that vitamin D is very good for your cardiovascular system, that protects your heart. It is very rich in calcium, that protects your bone and your teeth. It is very rich in beta carotene, and that helps, that gives two molecules of vitamin A, and that protects your eye, and of course it also protects your cataract. It can prolong. So there are lot of good chemical substances in egg, and I went through the literature and I found it was shocking that especially in Asia and Africa, the per capita consumption of egg is very poor. The egg consumption per capita is given That is, the maximum goes to Japan and Korea. Per capita, per annum, their consumption is very close to 400 eggs per annum, followed by Americans. Other European countries, very close to 300. But when you come to, for example, I was shocked to see that the per capita egg consumption in India is only 35. 35 eggs per annum, per capita consumption of egg. That's why, I mean, children are malnourished. They are suffering from deficiency of different type of vitamin and minerals because they are not properly fed. And egg is the best food for children, even for adults, for everybody. There is no reason that why, I mean, we are not giving enough egg to our population. Even in Nigeria, if you go to school children, you make the inquiry, you will see that they are not eating eggs. And the best way that if they are supplying them breakfast, my recommendation, let all children in secondary school or primary school should be given one egg if the breakfast is supplied freely. So in that case, let them include the egg. It is so important because it covers all your deficiency. And from childhood, you can get enough protein. Also, I was terribly shocked to know that most of the Nigerians, I'm talking of masses, I'm not talking of elite, they cannot afford one egg per day. The reason is they don't have purchasing power. That's why, even if you produce a lot, scientifically, you can say that we have a lot of surplus food, grain, egg, whatever. But whether affordability is there or not, whether people are going to afford that thing or not, this is the question mark, and here science fails. If we are producing a lot, at the same time, people should be able to afford to buy it and to use it. That is the most important part for the consumption of egg. And really, I mean, I wish that in India, drastically, they should increase the consumption of egg. And at least it should reach up to 200 per capita per annum. I mean, 35, 40 eggs is nothing. So that is the most important thing, and I am going to give one by one, point wise, what are the constituents in egg. Here, egg may help to prevent heart attack. For more than 50 years, doctors have told us that eating eggs causes heart attacks, but a recent research publication in the Journal of the American Medical Association shows that eggs may prevent heart attacks. Eggs can raise the good cholesterol, that is HDL, by 2%. Eggs can contain heart attack preventing vitamin D, retinol, folic acid, vitamin B12, calcium, monounsaturated fat. Yeah, in continuation, so egg is the most versatile protein, or we can say food, what we are using. First, it is very easy to cook, and secondly, it is very rich in variety of, I mean, vitamins and minerals, beta carotene, B complex, folic acid, lot of others. And then secondly, this is the purest form and cheapest protein. Cheapest protein means if you take the weight of egg and the weight of, for example, in Nigeria, the beef meat or goat meat is roughly, it ranges from 1,500 to 2,000 naira per kilogram. And if you take 1 kilogram by weight, the egg protein, it will not cost more than 500 naira. I'm sure about it. 1 kilo egg, after removing its coating, skin, if you take the only yellow yolk and albumin, it will not be more than 500 naira in India. Most of the meats, they cost roughly 300-400 rupees per kilo. Or sometimes maybe 600 rupees, but 1 kilo of egg in India will not cost more than 50 rupees. So this is also one of the best, that this is egg is the cheapest protein. And this in egg, what we call it, egg white, that is translucent, that egg white is very, very good ingredient for your digestion. It makes your digestive system very smooth. And yellow one, you know, it's very rich. So all is good for egg. Egg is nature's most perfect package of nutrition. Most perfect package of nutrition. It is naturally packed. There's no chance of any adulteration. For other meats, if you are taking, even sometimes there is chance of total substitution in place of, for example, sometimes beef in Nigeria, they may sell camel meat. Sometimes in place of your ram or goat meat, they may sell dog or donkey meat. But in egg, there is no such type of adulteration is possible. It is naturally sealed and absolutely unadulterated. Egg protein is one of the highest quality. Its biological value is 96, is highest as compared to other foods. Egg contains vitamin A, B carotene. It is good for eye. Vitamin D and calcium is good for bone and teeth. Vitamin E is good for your skin. All these, what I am mentioning, they are all found in your yellow yolk, which some 40 years before, the doctors were saying it is full of saturated fatty acid and cholesterol and it is dangerous. It was wrong. It is very rich in unsaturated fatty acid also. And all these beta carotenoids, they are very powerful antioxidants. They are responsible of clearing the free radicals from your body. So egg is the most important food. And there is no reason to say that egg is harmful. I mean, for cardiovascular system, good for bone and teeth. Vitamin E is good for skin. Carotenoid pigments present in egg yolk are natural antioxidants, which reduces the risk of heart attack. It contains folate, that is very important for your blood system. Thank you very much.